Welcome back. Turn of events really in Tamil Nadu. Now we have a full-time chief minister in the state, Edappadi Palanisamy, the proxy that Sasikala installed just before she went to jail, along with the deputy general secretary of the party, her nephew, TTV Dinakaran. They are back. The Manargadi family, many believe, will control the actions of Palanisamy. Will he end up being a puppet? It's very clear now. If Jayalalitha had OPS, Sasikala now has EPS. Edappadi Palanisamy, the next chief minister of Tamil Nadu, the current chief minister of Tamil Nadu, took the oath of office today along with 30 of his colleagues as ministers, largely the same cabinet that was in place previously. My colleague Lokapriya will be joining us right now. In fact, she is with us. Lokapriya, even after pro-Sasikala and Jayalalitha slogans were heard during the swearing-in ceremony in front of the governor and all the dignitaries, many believe that could perhaps potentially be a contempt of court. We now hear that Palanisamy, along with his ministers, will go to the Jaya Memorial to pay his tribute. There's also the possibility now of Palanisamy making the trek to the Agra Hara jail in Bangalore. Any confirmation on that yet?
Well, that's correct. We are getting to hear that Edappadi Palanisamy, along with his cabinet ministers, might go and visit Sasikala at the prison in Bengaluru. But there is no confirmation at the moment. But yes, the very fact that amidst chorus of Long Live Chinnamma, the vote was administered to all the MLAs, all the ministers, in fact. So the chief minister, after he was administered oath, there were chorus of Long Live Chinnamma. So here is a person who is convicted and who is lodged in jail, but her name was taken even in the presence of the governor. So this goes on to indicate the kind of power and clout Sasikala will be wielding in the party despite her conviction. And her family members were also present in the front row. Dinakaran was present. He is the Deputy General Secretary of the AIADMK. He was present at the swearing-in ceremony. So all these are indicators that Sasikala's family is here to stay and they will play a major role.
Right, Lokapriya, stay on with us. Some visuals coming in and some breaking news as well. We are expecting callers. First, we take breaking news coming in. Political clashes underway already between newly appointed Minister C.V. Shanmugam, his supporters, and O. Paneerselvam supporters. These are visuals, dramatic ones coming in from outside O. Paneerselvam's residence. And people in a show of defiance, really showing their claws, if you will. And already it seems that there are forces at work that will make sure that threats, cajoling, coercing, if that doesn't work, then a show of strength will be perhaps what will be a pattern during the next 15 days. Intimidation, clearly, outside O. Paneerselvam's office. C.V. Shanmugam, who was the newly sworn in minister, his supporters have clashed with OPS supporters outside O. Paneerselvam's residence. Here, these are shots coming outside O. Paneerselvam's residence in Chennai. Heavy police deployment. Despite that, supporters now trying to intimidate the supporters of O. Paneerselvam. We'll take a look at those shots yet again. And this is what's happening in Tamil Nadu right now. We are inviting callers to call us right now. The numbers are flashing on your screen, 01204369674. Do call us. And if you live in Tamil Nadu, definitely call us. We would like to hear your opinion on what's playing out right now on our television screens and television screens across the country right now. This has been national news for 10 days. It remains to be seen how long it'll continue to completely dominate and monopolize national airtime. Let's go across to my colleague Jay Prakash. He's in Bangalore. Jay Prakash, what we're seeing right now and what we've seen earlier during the oath ceremony is clearly indicative that the Sasikala faction will not shy away from flexing their muscles, physical or otherwise.
Absolutely. So that has been showcased now at the Raj Bhavan, even as Chinnamma's name echoed after the newly inducted ministers took oath. In fact, a lot of these ministers, leading from their chief minister, Edappadi Palanisamy, will be coming to Bangalore more quite often than ever, just because of the fact that Sasikala is here at Parapnagara Central Prison, and she is going to remote control the government sitting here. In fact, what has been an indication of this is trickling in of AIADMK cadres and supporters from Tamil Nadu, in fact, sitting here. In fact, what has been an indication of this is trickling in of AIADMK cadres and supporters from Tamil Nadu. In fact, we have with us one of them, a former member of parliament from Pollachi, Sukumaran. He is here. In fact, you know, we will catch up and ask him what he is doing in Bangalore. Sir, inga yen vandirkinga?
Cinema paakunga.
Eppo vandinga?
Neethu.
Appointment kadacha?
Appointment illa. Amma உயிரோடு இருந்து இன்னைக்கு அரெஸ்ட் ஆயிருந்தாங்கன்னா நம்ம இங்கே தானே இருப்போம். அது மாதிரி சின்னம்மா வந்ததுனால இங்கே வந்தோம்.
Till you meet her, you won't go from Bangalore.
But
till you meet Chinnamma, you will be here only.
No, I will be here for some days.
Clearly, he's come here to meet Chinnamma. He's not yet got the appointment. He says that he'll be, you know, stayed put here till he meets her. He wants to meet her and have a word with her. So he is a former parliamentarian from Pollachi. So this is going to be a trend in the coming days.
Absolutely,
even as
I completely agree with you there, Jayaprakash. We can see more and more Tamil Nadu politicians, especially if they are still loyal to Sasikala, making the trip now to the Agrahara prison in Bangalore. Lokapriya will be joining us as well in Chennai. But first, we'll take a caller. We remember are inviting callers right now. If you're in Tamil Nadu, if you're watching, do call. Let us know what you think. K. Mohan from Coimbatore is our first caller. Go ahead, Mr. Mohan.
In fact, I just happened to see that the chief minister, new chief minister, has taken oath. In fact, he's actually a proxy of Sasikala. Even if Jayalalitha would have been alive, all these people would have never been in the picture at all. If only she would have been just recovering in the hospital, Palanisamy only would have become chief minister. He represents the voice of Tamil Nadu people. And these MLAs, they don't abide by this voice of the aspirations of the Tamil people.
All right.
And in fact, Palanisamy only should be the person, right person.
All right. So Mr. Mohan, thank you for your comments and thank you for your concerns. Thank you for calling in. One more caller, Adi Shankar. Go ahead.
Yeah, good evening.
Good evening.
I'm Adi Shankar from Hyderabad.
Yes.
I have only one question.
Yeah.
I would like to know on what basis, like the new chief minister who has been appointed has been given 15 days to prove the majority.
All right, actually, that's a valid question. Well, I believe your answer lies in the discretion and the discretionary power of the governor, Vidyasagar Rao. Remember, he alone decides, at least constitutionally, how much time does an incumbent need to prove his majority on the floor of the House. Although that's a very good question, I'll try and incorporate that in my debates later. Thank you, Mr. Adi Shankar, for calling in. More breaking news. Meanwhile, coming in just now, our way, Tamil Nadu Chief Minister Edappadi Palanisamy will visit the Jayalalitha Memorial at Marina Beach in Chennai shortly. This is confirmation of what we've been telling you for a while now. He, along with his cabinet colleagues, is expected to go to the Jaya Memorial, pay his respects, pay the homage, as is now completely necessary. If you look at the events of the past 1 month or so, he will go to the Jaya Memorial, pay his respects, and then perhaps start his government in earnest. And also the immediate task in front of him, of course, would be to make sure his flock stays together and he still has the support of the 100 plus MLAs he has claimed in front of the governor. And when the floor test comes within the first 15 days, that of course can be shortened. Remember, he's gotten 15 days to prove the majority. If he does manage to get his affairs in order, a special session of the assembly could be called and he could prove his majority much before the 15-day period is about to end. That, of course, I'll have to ask the constitutional experts to get a confirmation on that, but it should be perhaps pretty safe to say that in case he wants to impress upon the governor that the special session should be called and the majority should be proven as soon as possible, he could do that. Now, latest visuals coming in, A. Palanisamy there already at the Jaya Memorial, putting flowers there and paying homage to the departed leader, Jayalalitha, former Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, former General Secretary of the AIADMK. There you go. That's the complete prostration, really, that we've seen in Tamil Nadu politics for a while. Palanisamy completely, absolutely prone body in front of the Jaya Memorial. We'll have to wait and watch if all the other cabinet ministers do the same. Yes, there you go. Another one completely prone in front of the Jaya Memorial. Palanisamy there along with his new cabinet, which is largely reflective of the old cabinet, is there at the Jaya Memorial in Chennai. That, of course, looks like Jaya Kumar, the fisheries minister. And there you go, one more again. One by one, swearing allegiance really on a meta level to none other than Jayalalitha, the departed leader and the chief minister, Amma as she was known, and still a towering figure even after her death in Tamil Nadu politics, a fulcrum of sorts really where all forces diverge is Jayalalitha. So the cabinet of Tamil Nadu, one by one, completely prone, prone bodies, prostrating in front of the Jayalalitha Memorial. Lokapriya, this was expected. We saw this coming as well. But this is also yet another part of the larger optics at play here. E. Palaniswamy there, his first job as full-time chief minister was to go to the Jaya Memorial and make sure that his cabinet was in tow, paying homage to Jayalalitha. His next task in earnest as full-time chief minister is going to be maintaining his flock and proving his majority at the earliest.
Well, definitely, as this is largely expected, it is all symbolic. Everybody wants to invoke the legacy of former Chief Minister J. Jayalalitha, and that is the reason why we are seeing, straight after being sworn in as the Chief Minister, Edappadi Palanisamy drove down right from Raj Bhavan to Jayalalitha Memorial at Marina Beach and paying respects to former Chief Minister Jayalalitha along with his cabinet ministers. Invoking Jayalalitha's legacy is very important because right now there is another faction in the AIADMK trying to claim legacy of Jayalalitha. So the bigger challenge for Palanisamy at this point in time will be to ensure that he keeps his flock together. He has the support of 125 MLAs. So for the next 15 days, till such time, a floor test is conducted. Edappadi Palanisamy needs to ensure that he has the majority, and that is going to be a challenge because the public mood is clearly against Palanisamy. The mandate is clearly against Palanisamy, and this was very witnessed very amply when these MLAs who were there at the resort were on their way back to Chennai. They were coming back in buses, and along the East Coast Road where they were on their way back to Chennai, we could hear the public abusing at them literally. So that is the kind of anger the public has. So it is going to be challenging for Palanisamy to remain neutral and to remain efficient even as he fights the criticism of being a proxy chief minister.
Absolutely. Just as Opani Silvam was the proxy chief minister for Jayalalitha, Edappadi Palanisamy is the proxy for Sasikala. Stay with us. I want to talk to you about what happened outside Upani Selvam's residence. But before I come back to you, Lokapriya, we have two callers. K. Dhanbalan from Bangalore. Go ahead, Mr. Dhanbalan.
Yeah, I'm Mr. K. Dhanbalan. Good evening to you.
Good evening.
I'd like to convey to the entire media, the Supreme Court has upheld the conviction of T.N. Kunha right from 2014 onwards.
Right.
So the conviction continues till from 2014. A convicted person, in between, he has applied for the remedy in the High Court. It is adjudicated. Further, it is appealed in the Supreme Court.
Right.
In the process, conviction is always continuing from 2014 only, has been reaffirmed in the Supreme Court.
Yes.
Order. A convict cannot be a general secretary of the nationally recognized party,
right.
AIADMK.
That's what the election commission is hearing right now. You're absolutely right there, Mr. Dhanbalan. The election commission is hearing that case right now. And Opani Selvam's best shot really is if the election commission overturns or deems null and void all the signatures that Sasikala made or wrote down while she was general secretary of the party, given the fact that her conviction stays. Thank you for joining us. We also have another caller right now. Vidya Ramesh is the next caller from Bangalore. Go ahead, Vidya.
Yeah, good evening.
Good evening.
Yeah, it's just I want to take out my frustration right now. It's not only my frustration, it's the frustration of the entire Tamil Nadu people. Though I live in Bangalore, every time I travel to Tamil Nadu to cast my vote. But today I'm very sorry that why I went last time to cast my vote in Tamil Nadu. I didn't go to vote for these people who are there. I didn't go to vote for these Mannarkudi mafia people over there. And then I want to condemn each and every one of the MLAs who were there in Kuthanur. We didn't cast our vote for them to go and enjoy in Kuthanur. They have to be, they didn't even do their thing, and I can understand that governor has to go by numbers. At the same time, he has to consider the public sentiments also.
Right.
And at the same time, I want to condemn Mr. Subramania Swamy when he...
Yes, Vidya? Seem to have lost Vidya there, Vidya Ramesh, of course. Yes, Vidya? Seem to have lost Vidya there. Vidya Ramesh, of course, started off by saying that she wanted to vent her frustration here. So it's a very politically volatile situation as far as we can see here. As my colleagues have been pointing out right now, at some point, all these MLAs who are still with the Sasikala faction and banging Palaniswamy right now will have to go back to their constituencies at some point. And the public sentiment largely, I wouldn't say completely, but largely is against the Manargudi family primarily. If Dinakaran's elevation to the Deputy General Secretary of the AIADMK is going to go by, we would see more and more involvement, at least, if not influence, of the Manargudi family in the day-to-day running of the Sasikala faction of the AIADMK. Now, at some point, these MLAs will have to go back to their constituencies, and will 15 days be enough for them to change their mind, or the constituents to make sure that they change their mind at all? We don't know. It's going to play out in the next 15 days, and we'll be there to cover it for sure. But on your screens right now, of course, are visuals of Palaniswamy, the newest Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, the current CM, going along with his cabinet to the Jayalalitha Memorial to pay his tribute and start his work as full-time Chief Minister in earnest. The biggest problem that Palaniswamy and the Sasikala faction could face right now in the next 15 days is the wrath and the ire of their own constituents, who largely do not want the Manargudi family to control who sits in the Chief Minister's chair. There's a lot of trust deficit as far as that particular family is concerned, although Sasikala has tried her best to keep the family away. But now that she's in jail, she'll need the family more than ever, and that's her conundrum. We'll come back to that in just a bit. Lokapriya is standing by in Chennai. Lokapriya, we saw some dramatic scenes outside Opaneer Selvam's residence. C.V. Sanmugam, minister who was recently sworn in right now, his supporters clashing with Opaneer Selvam supporters. There was stone pelting. There was some sort of vandalism. One person from the Shanmugam camp also climbed the window, of course, made some threatening gestures there as well. What exactly happened, and can we expect more such intimidation in the future?
Well, definitely, as we are right outside the residence of Paneer Selvam, and right now security has been tightened following the stone pelting incident, and the party cadres are not being allowed entry into Paneer Selvam's residence. From this point, Paneer Selvam's residence is about 500 meters. Remember, this is the government accommodation where judges and ministers are given accommodation. So Paneer Selvam and C.V. Shanmugam are neighbors. Their houses are located to next to each other. So there was a brief stone pelting that took place between supporters of C.V. Shanmugam and supporters of Paneer Selvam. Either of them blaming each other for starting this. But now the police have cleared the place. And one policeman was injured in a minor way. He has been given first aid. One party worker from OPS camp was also injured, suffered very minor injuries. He has also been given first aid, and security has been tightened here outside Paneer Selvam's residence. Party cadres are not being allowed inside. Only judges, in fact, the judges also stay in this same residential complex. So only those people are allowed inside,
right.
And the security has been stepped up following this incident that took place about 20 minutes ago.
Right, stand by, Lokapriya. We're getting more calls right now. Now, K. Manohar calling as well as Vandana. Go ahead, Mr. Manohar.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
I'm Manohar from Bangalore.
How are you, Manohar?
I'm fine, sir. Is this government, these MLAs have betrayed the people of Tamil Nadu? Are they really going to govern the people of Tamil Nadu? Are they going to help out only Sasikala in again doing further corrupt activities? Is it the same MLAs who are going to give the real government to the people of Tamil Nadu? This is not the way she has conducted herself. during these last few days after the death of Jayalalitha is not indicative enough that they'll give us a good government.
All right, Manohar, your fears, of course, have been repeated many times by a lot of people. Thank you for calling in. Vandana is our next caller. Go ahead, Vandana.
Good evening, good evening. I'm calling from Bangalore. I voted last year in Chennai in Virgambakkam constituency, and I even spoke to my MLA just now a few minutes back. I have been trying to reach him for a few days. And I told Mr. Virugai, V and Virugai Ravi, the MLA of the constituency, that, sir, please give your support to OPS, sir. And he said, okay, you have given me vote. What is the connection between you voting me and me voting for OPS? He asked this me in Tamil, and I haven't recorded that. I don't know how to record in the mobile. And I'm really worried. I'm really tense how Tamil Nadu is going to go forward. Because if you see, in 91 to 96, though Amma was there, but it was a complete Gundaraj.
All right.
And again, Sasikala and her company are coming back. And once they get the vote of trust, I'm very sure Dinakaran, Venkatesh, Jayachandran, everybody is going to come back to power. Which certainly is going to ruin Tamil Nadu.
All right. We'll have to wait and watch. We'll have to wait and watch. But we do understand there are apprehensions by a lot of voters, including ones like you. Vandana, thank you for calling in. We'll keep an eagle eye on proceedings in Tamil Nadu, as is our job, and we'll keep you updated. Please stay tuned to NewsX. We'll also go across now to my colleague in Bangalore, Jayaprakash. Jayaprakash, as you told us earlier, that there are MPs, even former MPs, leaders, as well as those still loyal to the Sasikala faction, making a beeline to the Agrahara prison in Bangalore. Now, that's going to be a pattern that we're going to see in the next 15 days, perhaps even after that, in case Palaniswamy does win the trust vote. But there are fears, and massive fears and apprehensions back in Tamil Nadu, especially by voters who don't want the Manargadi family to be running things in the ADMK yet again. I'm not really sure whether or not they have such a huge problem with Sasikala herself, but the family poses a problem, and Sasikala would know that. But now she's in a dilemma, because she had asked her family to disappear for a while, but now that she's in jail, she's going to need their clout more than ever. So she's in a bit of a catch-22 right now.
Absolutely. You just summed it all up as to how politics has changed in Tamil Nadu and how powers have changed hands now, even after the death of Jayalalitha. Though in the name of Jayalalitha, clearly the power is in the hand of Sasikala sitting here at Parapnagrara. As you rightly mentioned, a lot of leaders are trickling in from Hosur, which is the Bangalore, bordering a district of Bangalore. And then in the coming days, or probably coming years too, she has to serve 4 years jail term. This is going to be a power center. Though they know that, you know, they can't meet her, it's just that, that there is a presence of Sasikala here, and they just want to be seen around. They just want to come here just to have and feel the fact that their Chinnamma is here. And sitting in Bengaluru, she's going to remote control the government. In fact, if I can ask my camera person to just tilt the camera and show how platoons and platoons of policemen have been deployed by the city police. In fact, they expect a lot of VVIPs coming from Chennai tomorrow, because the jail is closed for now for visitors at 5:30. So information is that they have sought an appointment to meet Sasikala tomorrow morning. Chief Minister Edappadi Palanisamy and his battery of cabinet ministers, 31 of them, they're all expected to land here to take the blessings of their beloved Chinnamma, as she is called, even as the police are making arrangements here. So tomorrow there will be more deployment. So definitely there's some kind of an anxiety and palpable situation here in Bangalore, because yesterday we saw some, you know, untoward incidents, a couple of car being smashed, and today there have been some arrests in that connection. So they expect some kind of trouble, because there is mixed emotions, mixed reactions coming from Bangalore, even as OPS supporters and Amma supporters are against Sasikala taking the center stage in Tamil Nadu politics. So they're clearly showing their anger against the current dispensation, which is going to rule Tamil Nadu for the next 4 years. So that has been the case. We, in fact, tracked down that Vivek, who's Ilavarasi's son, who apparently is the heir apparent to Poyas Garden. He was here. He's still here with his lawyers. He updated Sasikala throughout the day as to what was happening in Tamil Nadu, all the political updates he was giving to her. We, in fact, saw him stepping out of the jail. And he, in fact, has sought appointment for the new chief minister and his cabinet ministers. It is all at the discretion of the jail superintendent, Krishna Kumar, we have to see how we views it, because it's the head of another state who's coming to meet a convict. So he has to take a decision as to how he has to give an appointment for this meeting to happen here at Paratnagrara. There are two types of meeting. When I inquired about the prison manuals and the jail authorities, they say that there is an ordinary meeting and then there's a personal meeting. In the ordinary meeting, there is a bar between the visitor and the convict. In the personal meeting, where there is a room, they allow these visitors to meet the other person who's the convict. So it all depends on how the arrangements are made. Tomorrow is a big day at Paratnagrara. We'll have to wait and see what happens tomorrow at this very place. There's going to be a lot of action here.
Right.
Back to Athar.
Absolutely. And there will be action in the coming days as well, Jayaprakash, if indications are anything to go by. And there will be action in the coming days as well, Jayaprakash, if indications are anything to go by. O Paneer Selvam is not going to give up so easily. There is still really a groundswell of support. I wouldn't say pro O Paneer Selvam. It's largely anti-Manargadi and anti-Sasikala, controlling the government by remote control. So it's not really a positive vote. It's largely a negative vote. Not a vote, I beg your pardon. Sentiment. A negative sentiment against the Manargadi family coming back into the thick of things and running the AIADMK. Dinakaran's presence has unnerved many in Tamil Nadu, and they believe, some of the callers calling in right now also expressing their concerns and apprehensions over the very same fact. One more caller calling in right now, Shyam from Chennai. Go ahead, Shyam.
Yeah, good evening to all of you.
Yes.
I just have three observations to make. Point number one is that why has the governor not made any kind of investigation as to why these people are held captive? Is it because of the fact that these people have been held captive by force and they do not want to open their mouths? That is a big concern which comes out here. The second most important thing, I think this is a message I would like to give to the people of Tamil Nadu, is that be patient, because this is only a temporary rubber stamp government, and we feel that this will collapse because this is basically a horse trading kind of a set up. So I don't think it's everybody has actually given in, any of the MLAs have actually given in to the heart. It's only purely because of these monkey trading or horse trading that we actually
have. All right. Thank you for calling in, Shyam. One more caller then. Sarda, go ahead.
Yeah, we are very disappointed today.
Yes, go ahead.
Hello.
Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, that is what, because the MLAs have not come out and they were kept as captives. And how can this be a proper, how can they be elected like this? It is so, we are so worried. Then what is the purpose we vote for?
All right. Thank you, Sarda, for calling in. Not the first time we've heard that refrain today, and it won't be the last. I can assure our viewers that a lot of apprehensions about how members of a particular family could perhaps be in. Is the fix in? Is the big question. We'll take a short break right now. We'll come back with more on the other side. Stay tuned.